Hi everybody, happy Engineers Day to all the engineers out there. Today is the birthday of Saram Vishweshwaraya, a world renowned engineer and one of the piece of engineering marvel is actually a KRS dam that was constructed under his supervision. And KRS is Krishnaraja Sagara dam, which is built across the river Kaveri in the state of Karnataka, which is in India. So he also served as the Diwan and minister during the reign of Nalvadi Krishnaraja Vadayar, or Krishnaraja Vadayar the fourth, during whose reign Mysore was considered as a model state. So the king had all these able people under him. Saram Vishweshwaraya, Diwan Purnaya, and all these people who really worked selflessly and made the state a model state. This was pre-independence era. And so once again, I wish all the engineers a very happy day, and enjoy your day. And on this day, since it is Engineers Day, I will just talk about a different type of engineering called inner engineering. So if you already know about Isha Foundation and I've been following Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, you know what I'm talking about. If not, it is actually it's a yoga and spirituality kind of foundation that is actually founded by Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev. This campus is based in, or the ashrama is based in a place closer to Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. And Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev is originally from Mysuru. He has done his initial education in Mysuru. And so this inner engineering program actually is I can call it as a personality development program, which helps us find a balanced perspective in our life. It is actually designed keeping all the five layers of our existence, this physical body, or the what you call as Annamaya Kosha, and then the pranic sheath, or the Pranamaya Kosha, and then the mind layer, which is Manomaya Kosha, and then the Vijnanamaya Kosha, or the intellect sheath, intellectual sheath of our existence, and then finally the Anandamaya Kosha, or the blissful sheath. So this inner engineering program, if you attend in person, it is a 7-day course. If you have go to any of the Isha centers, then it's a 7-day course, and they offer it in the ashrama also. But in the prevailing health scare situation, or the COVID situation, I think this course is being offered online as well. And for a I think they were running a very that's a program at a very affordable cost, and that was a really a noble gesture from Isha Foundation. They were offering it at 50% off for all the people, and it was completely free for COVID warriors who are actually, like, for example, doctors or anybody in the front line offering assistance to the people affected by COVID. Those can get this program for free. I have done this inner engineering course, so that is why I was telling that I am an inner engineer. There is a Isha center very close to my place in Mysuru, and I did this program back in August 2018, and my experience has been really good, actually. What does this course involve? I'll just give you a brief overview. There are a set of exercises, or the asanas, which is called as Upa Yoga. So you can search it on YouTube. You will get very good videos given by Isha Foundation itself, where there's a demonstration of these Upa Yoga asanas. And then we also learn how to do some of the pranayama exercises, and then how to look at the things in life with the right perspective. Because sometimes what happens is we tend to blame things. Sometimes, in most of the time, we tend to blame others, or tend to blame the situations and the external factors for what we are and how we feel. So we forget to take the ownership of our own actions or how we feel. So the one key thing that we are taught, or we are made to practice, is taking ownership of our own actions. So that is the key, because it's very easy to say, but to put it into practice, we have to really try, because to blame others it's very easy. And then we are also taught, like, you know, we are actually given some exercises where we have to write down how we would deal with the different situations, whether it is a happy or joyous occasion or some difficult situations that we might have gone through in our life, and how did we react, and you know, did this program help us to look at those things differently. So this also, actually this particular exercise as part of this Isha's inner engineering course helps us to change how our mindset, how we look at the things. And then when we have a control over our mind and emotions, it helps us just clear up our intellectual layer, because we are born with it, and it just gets clouded by our emotions and attachments. So once that is cleared, our discerning power is back. And then when we look at things with a different perspective, like trying to help others, and we are also actually during this program, by doing various activities as part of this course, we get a couple of opportunities to think in terms of how we can help others, you know, without expecting anything in return. So the actual meaning of service, the karma yoga, you know, doing things without any expectations. So that actually gives greater happiness, and that's the real happiness. So that we get to experience that bliss, actual real happiness by doing that. And the final day, the seventh day, we actually as a group come together, and along with Isha volunteers, and we play certain games like yogic games, things that then we used to play, like some keeping some actions and saying some words, and when there's some number comes, you should not say that number, instead of that say some other code word. And then we all played throwing the ball, why we do these things is when we come together as a group, we just forget about who we are, and what background we come from, our age, everything, and then we mingle there as a just a group, as a human being. And it was really good, because we had people who were in still high school, and then who were doing their engineering degree, and somebody was doing their BSc or BCom degree. The kids were there, and then people like me who are into the workforce and householders, and they were also elderly folks, like 60 to 70 years old people. And we all in the playground, we were just, when we were playing, we didn't know, we were just yelling and having fun. That was really good. That is the actual blissful state that we had. And later in the afternoon of the concluding day, the seventh day, we got initiated into what we call as Shambhavi Kriya. There's a particular sequence. This is actually should be done only by the qualified guru. So even the trainer who had come, I'm not saying he wasn't qualified, but he didn't do that particular initiation step. It was actually done through a video in which Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev himself gave us the initiation. So the instructor that we had was really good. Believe it or not, he is actually an American, and he got influenced by Jaggi Vasudev's personality and his work. And when he was doing a philosophy course in the US, he heard about this program. He came here and he lived in the ashram, and then later he just decided to stay in India and become part of Isha Foundation. So he explained his experience, and he was the one that we had as a trainer. And we got the initiation, and then we were asked to practice it for 40 days, Shambhavi Mudra and the Kriya that we had to do every day for 40 days without a break, in the morning and the evening for 40 days continuously. And there was a support group that was formed by the Isha volunteers here, and they supported us with any questions, anything that we had, and made sure that we stayed on course and completed that mandala. Because if you do anything consistently for 21 days, that's what you might have read, right? So anything you do consistently for 21 days becomes a habit. So this 40 days of continuous Kriya, it helps us internalize that whole process of meditation. So we completed it, and then that after that you have to practice it every day. And so once you do it, it just becomes part of your life, and it's your second nature. So you do it without being told, or you don't have to make an effort to do it. So that really helps us to keep a balanced perspective. So that is my experience. A disclaimer, because many people think that I might be doing a promotion for Isha Foundation. No. The Isha Foundation and Jaggi Vasudev's team don't need any promotion. You know, they're already famous, and I'm not getting paid for this video either. And actually, I'm just sharing my experience because I am on this yogic path, and there are so many people now getting anxious many people are getting depressed because of this COVID situation, and something like this program will really help us to clear our mind and get our balance back. That is why I'm talking about it. And also, this has this inner engineering, so we can become a better person, not only just a engineer, a regular engineer. So once again, happy Engineers Day, everybody. Stay happy, healthy, and safe all the time. Keep smiling. Happy Engineers Day.